What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating zones within your Palo Alto Virtual Machine 10.0, because that's what I'm using right now to play around. So let's get right into it. All right, so yes, I have been playing around with a new firewall, which is PAVM, Palo Alto Virtual Machine. It's actually running software version 10.0.4, is the eval version. And the reason why I've been playing around with this particular firewall is because my 9-to-5 job is actually using or is going to upgrade into this environment. And I'm just playing around and getting myself prepared with a couple of things. And today is all about creating zones, because that's the first thing that I'm learning how to do. And then, you know, doing some NATs and security policies and all that other good stuff. So this is how I learn. If there's another way and you guys have used this particular firewall, leave comments right below. I would love to learn from you guys because, again, this is all new to me. So this is how I created my zones. On the dashboard, I went into networks, and within networks, I went into zones. Within zones, I didn't have anything, so I needed to go all the way to the left, to the bottom, and click on add. And I needed to add my first zone. My first zone that I created was LAN. And I clicked on log settings, and I clicked on new. I clicked on log forwarding. I gave my log forwarding profile a new name. I gave it this, and I clicked on add. And once I clicked on add, I needed to provide log forwarding profile match list. So I gave it the following name. For log type, I gave it threats. For filters, I gave it all logs. Once I set up my filters to all logs, I wanted to take these logs and push it somewhere else, so to like a system log server. So within the system log server section, I clicked on add. Once I clicked on add, I clicked on new system log profile, and it took me here. I gave it the following name, and I clicked on add. And I needed to add a name and my system log server IP address, so I gave it the following. I clicked OK. And once everything was set within the log forwarding profile match list, I clicked OK. This is what I want. I clicked OK again, and then bam, we're good to go. Now, the next thing that I did within this zone for my LAN zone is I clicked on the type, and it's going to be a layer 3. Once I set my type, I went all the way to the bottom to the zone protection profile. I clicked on the drop-down menu. I don't have anything, so I clicked on new, and I clicked on zone protection profile. Within here, I gave my zone protection profile a name, and I configured the following settings. Now, for the flood protection, I basically enabled everything by default. There's probably best practice somewhere, but if you guys do know, leave them at the comment section or just DM me directly and hey, say, Bernardo, you're doing it wrong. You need to do this and this. You know, I'm here to learn. On the next tab, I think the following things that I did was I enabled everything. And on the action, I just basically blocked everything. On the next tab, which is the packet-based attack protection, on the IP drop, I think I enabled spoof IP address, strict source routing, loose source routing, unknown, and malform. Those are the ones that I enabled. On the TCP drop, I enabled the following, which was mismatch overlapping, split handshake, and TCP timestamp. Once I did all that stuff here within my zone protection profile, I clicked on OK, and I was done with my LAN. So I clicked OK. Awesome. Now, there is another way to do the zone protection profile. So I did it another way. You could do it actually within the zones. But if you go on your left-hand side, you're going to see an option that says zone protection. So click on it. You're going to see the one that we created. So if you select the one that we created, and you go to the bottom and you clone it, because I want to create another one. And the other one that I'm going to create is going to be for my WAN, my WAN zone. So I cloned it. I'm going to select the one that I clone. I'm going to rename it to this outside zone protection profile, because again, it's going to be for my WAN zone. I left the flood protection as is, and I went to the packet-based attack protection. And the only thing that I did here was uncheck spoof IP addresses. And then I clicked OK, and I was already done with this zone protection. So I went back inside zone. I clicked on add. I gave it a name. You guessed it, WAN. For the log setting, I clicked on the drop-down menu, and I picked the profile that I created before. For my type, I clicked on the drop-down menu, and it's going to be a layer 3. And for my zone protection profile, I clicked on the drop-down menu and I picked the one that I created, which was called Outside Zone Protection. Once I did all that, I clicked OK. Now, the last thing that I did within my firewall to complete my zone setup was to go inside device. Within device, I went into setup. Within setup, I went into sessions. And within session settings, you want to locate packet buffer protection and make sure that's enabled. And that's it. I think the last thing that we need to do is click on commit, which is located at the upper right side. Just click on commit. It's going to basically give you all the changes that you made and you want to commit them. Click on commit. It's going to start committing all the changes. And once it's done, you should get this, which is awesome. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.